Let's not talk now to the Labour MP for Aberavon, Stephen Kinnock, who is a Remain voter and a member of the Exiting the EU Select Committee. Stephen, thanks very much for being with us on BBC News this morning. First of all, the speech itself. Do you think she got the tone right?
I think the problem is that it was another speech which set out what she wants, but without any sense of how to get there. And what's ironic, I think, is when she sets out what she wants, things like, yes, implementing the decision of the people, finding an enduring solution, protecting our prosperity, delivering an outcome consistent with the country we want to be, the answer to all those questions is an EFTA, European Economic Area, based Brexit. An EFTA EEA Brexit does deliver a very high degree of market access, but you're not subject to the jurisdiction of the ECJ, and you can strike trade deals with other countries.
But you can't contribute to the rulemaking, and that's always been a stumbling block, isn't it? A lot of people say, I mean, the example that, I mean, I've been to Norway and they said, yeah, it's great, actually we it suits us because we didn't want to be in the EU, but it is still, I mean, they used to call it fax democracy because they get the instructions sent to them. I don't think anyone faxes it now, presumably it's email democracy, but the principles are the same.
I would contest that. If you look at the EEA Joint Committee, you look at the whole plethora of working groups, technical groups, where Norway has a associate status. The fact
so you argue because they're in the meetings during the process, they can influence it even if they don't get a vote at the end. Is that what you're saying?
I mean, I lived and worked in Brussels for many years, and the fact is the vast majority of decisions made in Brussels are made on the basis of consensus. Do we seriously think that if the UK was in the EEA and there was some new directive coming forward on financial services, that the UK wouldn't have a very important voice in that decision-making process?
Let's look at a couple of the specific things she said, because I appreciate you're saying she hasn't given us a route to how she chooses things. But there were a number of things she said. She said, for example, some of these organisations we've heard a lot about, the European Atomic Energy Agency, the Air Transport Agency. She said, look, our proposal is we have associate membership, we sign up to the regulations, we'll even put some money in the pot. That sounds like a practical solution.
Again, an EFTA EEA-based Brexit would give the actual framework, the architecture to do that across a range of agencies.
In the absence of that, it's not an unreasonable suggestion to come up with, is it?
It's not, but again, the government hasn't done its homework. Of the 50-odd EU agencies there are, about half of them, there is no provision at all for a third country to be involved at all.
But there could What she's saying, surely, is this is an opportunity for creative solutions. And you've worked in Brussels for many years. Your wife is a former prime minister of an EU member nation, and an EU member nation that at times has been quite sceptical, has negotiated opt-outs. We negotiated opt-outs as members. There are ways around these problems. There are always ways if the will is there, surely.
Yes, but given the incredibly short time frame that we have, the fact is that this negotiation is like building a house. You need to, first of all, decide on the foundations. The foundations will be an off-the-shelf model, either Norway, either Canada, or another off-the-shelf model.
So the bespoke option isn't there.
But then you build the rest of your house. Decide the foundations first, then argue about the doors, the windows, and the roof. And the problem fundamentally with the government is they haven't been able to accept that you need that model as the basis for the negotiations going forward. We are now 3 weeks away from the EU signing off the guidelines for the future relationship phase of the talks. It is absolutely extraordinary that Theresa May is still talking about all the things we could do without any real blueprint or roadmap for the future. And I think that's a massive abdication of the duty and responsibility of the British government.
Stephen Kinnock, Labour MP for Aberavon. Thanks very much.
Thank you.